to bring them in, authorize them as regular county employees and no longer contract with a temporary agency for those positions. The people who are in those positions have been very dedicated, very loyal, have accepted their status as temporary employees for some period of time in most cases, and have done a good job for the county in doing so. We would initially offer them a regular employment status, and depending on their reaction, then we would list those vacancies. The one that's a little different than that is the actual director of the department. As you know, that's an interim position at this point, and it wasn't completely clear that that was funded as part of the budget, so this corrects that as well.
Do we have a direct cost on that, too?
The totals, Mr. Chairman, I recall, are about $15,000 increase overall from what our current staffing plan program is. And the total cost for that, Mr. Chairman, is just over $181,000 for the time.
And this brings these positions on this full time?
Yes, ma'am, if you authorize that.
And just say again, Jim, these people that we're looking at, the number was five.
Six total.
Six total?
Yes,
that include the interim director?
That includes the interim director.
And several of these people here have been, they've been on temp service with us for over 5 years.
Yes, sir. That's my understanding.
I thought it was four in liquor tax and two in records management, making six, and then the interim director would be seven.
The four in liquor tax is inclusive of the interim director.
Okay, inclusive.
That's correct. And $181,000 would be the cost for the five contract employees that we currently employ. So that would not include the interim director position. That's the total cost.
That's the total cost, that's not an increase.
The increase as we evaluated was in the ballpark range or rounding range of 15,000.
Yes.
Annually. Just so we would like for you to amend the budget. Of course, that would take three readings, so that would transfer the funds that were designated as cap funding to the liquid tax. Transition of the contract employees to regular employment status if you approve the authorization of those positions. And then the other is what we would like committee members to do going forward, to continue with you to monitor the revenue and expenditure trends and refinement of our projections and the report that had to you monthly as updates, and make recommendations as a come to us and as you direct. Also, we would like to include in that monthly reporting to you the monitoring of our health insurance claims experience, as well as how our self-funded program is operating, and any budgetary remedies as may be needed as we go throughout the fiscal year. Our goal here, Mr. Chairman, is not to stand before you in April or May and say, we have a problem we need you to fix. We would prefer to work together and recognize if there are problems, and I'm not suggesting that there will be, but if there are, that we correct them going along.
Is there any further questions or comments? This time, could I entertain a motion that we have the first reading?
Second.
Motion and second. All those in favor, let me know by the raise of the right hand. So moved. Now, the second item coming before today is to receive information and take desired action in reference to authorizing the addition of six positions to the general fund, authorizing staffing level for the fiscal year beginning July the 1st, 2011, and ending June the 30th, 2012. Mr. Hip, you're back on board again.
Yes, sir. Mr. Chairman, that just formalizes the action that I just requested with the positions relative to the delinquent tax and records management, and you can do so by action of council without
about this.
exciting projects to talk to you about tonight. And the first one has to do with an old mill that's well over 100 years old that has potential. It's called the Clifton Mill. It has potential to be a really nice new retirement park. What we're asking you to do tonight is to express, and I'll emphasize this, conceptual support for the proposed project and the expenditure of hospitality tax funds that we estimate somewhere between $10,000 to $15,000. That would be the local match for a feasibility study before we move forward. And in your in the resolution that you have, we have one addition of one word that helps clarify that. Prior to it, or what you have before you, says now therefore be resolved that Spartanburg County Council endorses the change in the waterway land acquisition project to include the possible acquisition and redevelopment approach in a fairly systematic step-by-step fashion. The first step is a feasibility study, assuming that you did get the grant and have been assured that there's a good possibility of that. And then we also believe there's probably funding for the removal of the dam, which I noted up there in the picture, and that will require some degree of local match. We don't know how much yet. And then clean up the site, and once the site is cleaned up, then we purchase the land, and we'll be bringing that recommendation to y'all at that time. So before anything could actually happen on purchasing the land and turning this into a park, probably 2 to 2.5 years is going to elapse. And for that reason, that's one of the reasons that we suggested moving the funds from that outdoor adventure center, which in meeting with council, I did not hear any support for that project. And so I would consider that to be a defunct project at this point, and it would be better suited spent on the waterway land acquisition, if not here, in other places along the back of the Tiger River.
Jim, let me start out. When we're looking at down here in the long part of the blue where we're transferring, possibility of transferring $200,000 from the Outdoor Adventure Center. That brings up the question, how much money do we have in
$200,000. Basically, our recommendation is just to erase that project.
My concern is when you're talking about owner removable of all salvageable material is underway. This is an old mill. Has there been any analysis of the soil or the water around this mill site to clear it of any harmful?
We understand there was a phase one environmental assessment done some years ago.
Do you have that report?
Do you have a report?
And what does it say?
Very positive.
Very positive.
Yeah, it's good. Essentially, the phase one is kind of an eye test, so there wasn't any testing done on the soils. Yeah, that'll come later phase of environmental assessments. I can tell you that the mill used there was not a dying mill, which typically those were the most.
What was it used for?
From the best I can tell, it actually had lines of big spools that were actually used to.
It wasn't a dying pension
plant? No, it wasn't.
What was the dam there for? For just for power?
Provide power to the mill.
Okay. When you talk about salvageable material, what has he identified as salvageable? Will it be the whole mill structure? Is he going to bring it down?
Yes.
Okay, and he's going to clear off that property when he does so?
That's still to some degree under discussion. On the newer part of the mill, there's a concrete slab that he would like to leave there. We have talked about that. Should all this work out okay, that could be the base, for example, for picnic shelters.
Concrete slabs are usually left there because there's something underneath. I want to make sure there's nothing underneath.
Sure.
Dale, I know I'm on the committee, but the company that actually owns the property now came to us and came to O'Neill as well, and Dr. George Fields has been involved in this. They are going to take down the whole building, sell brick. It's got a lot of value to it. He wanted to offer it to us first. Because it has a great it's great potential, great opportunity, especially when we're talking about any of these waterways. And Dr. Fields has been in conversation with Mayor Harris.